Hello everyone, welcome to HW News. The chairman of Delhi Minority Commission, Zafarul Islam Khan, has been charged under sedition by special cell of Delhi Police. Now the FIR was filed on April 30 after receiving a complaint from the resident of Delhi's Vasant Kunj. He has been charged under 124A, IPC section 124A, which is sedition, and 153A, which is promoting enmity between different groups on the basis of religion, race and place of birth. The FIR, the complaint by the Delhi's Vasant Kunj resident, had clearly mentioned that his tweet, his social media post was provocative, it was deliberate, and it intended to create a rift between the society and it intended to create disharmony in the society. But what was that post? We will tell you about it, but let me give you a quick context. You might remember that few days ago there was a barrage of fake news and Islamophobic tweets against Indian Muslims, especially after the Tablighi Jamaat episode, and it received a severe backlash from the Middle East countries including Kuwait and UAE, where several scholars from these two countries especially took it to Twitter and they stood up to the Islamophobia that was going on in the country. Now thanking Kuwait for standing up against this Islamophobia, Zafarul Islam Khan had written this particular post. However, he also mentions Zakir Naik in it. Now Zakir Naik is absconding from India. Now Zakir Naik is a controversial Islamic preacher who has been accused by India of terror funding, and India is also trying for a red corner notice against him by the Interpol. So let us quickly go through what exactly was a controversial post written by Zafarul Islam Khan. In his Facebook post, Zafarul Islam Khan had written that the Hindutva bigots calculated that given the huge economic stakes involved, the Muslim and Arab world will not care about the persecution of Muslims in India. The bigots forgot that Indian Muslims enjoy huge goodwill in the eyes of Arab and Muslim world for their service over centuries to Islamic causes, excellence in Islamic and Arabic scholarship, cultural and civilizational gifts to world heritage. Names like Shah Walilullah Dehlavi, Iqbal, Abul Hasan Nadvi, Wahiduddin Khan, Zakir Naik and many others are respected household names in the Arab and Muslim world. Mind you, bigots, Indian Muslims have opted until now not to complain to the Arab and Muslim world about your hate campaigns and lynchings and riots. The day they are pushed to do that, bigots will face an avalanche. This post was written by him on April 28, 2020. However, 2 days later, there was a complaint filed against him. After the FIR against him, Zafarul Islam Khan posted a statement of his on his Twitter account and he apologized for his earlier post. He said that the tweet issued by him on 28th of April 2020 thanking Kuwait for taking note of the persecution of Indian Muslims in the context of Northeast District's violence has pained some people, which never was his intention. He further wrote, "I realized that my tweet was ill-timed and insensitive in view of the country facing a medical emergency and fighting an unseen enemy. I apologize to all whose sentiments were hurt. Further, the limitation of a tweet, which has to be a very short by its very nature, was also responsible that the whole narrative was not made out in plain language. The matter was blown out of all proportions by adding things into it which was neither my intention nor was meant. A section of media added lies into it, distorted and fabricated its content and attributed inflammatory opinion into it. I did not say so nor intended such things as they have been attributed to my tweet. I have already stated in my previous statement as to how I have defended India in the Arab world on crucial issues." He said that "I will continue to do so, far from complaining against my country to any other country or Arab or Muslim world. This is against our constitution, against my own views, upbringing and against my religious belief, which teaches me that love of homeland is part of Islam." He further said that "I have taken serious note of section of media which distorted my tweet and attributed to me things I never said.
Appropriate legal notices have already been served on the news channel which championed in distorting my statement. If need be, further legal steps shall be also taken. However, he further said that he thanks all his friends and well-wishers who stood by him in solidarity during this difficult time, and he assured them that their struggle against bigotry and hate politics will continue within his institution and within the framework of Constitution, which is the sole reference point of our polity. However, 2 days later, he again issued a clarification and he said that his tweet was not deleted and he stands by his tweet. He said that it has been erroneously reported in a section of media that he had apologized for the tweet and deleted it, but he said that he has not apologized for the tweet and has not deleted it. He said that I have apologized not for the tweet itself, but because it was ill-timed and insensitive in the midst of a medical emergency faced by the country. The tweet is very much there on his Twitter handle and Facebook page. Moreover, he further said that he stands by his views and convictions. He said, I will continue now and in future the fight against hate politics in the country. FIRs, arrest and imprisonment do not change this path which he has chosen consciously to save his country, his people and the Indian secular polity and the constitution.
However, his social media post thanking Kuwait did not go well with Indian Muslims and even with several Indians who slammed him for making such a post. Now, after receiving a severe backlash, he even issued a clarification and he even apologized for his previous tweet. BJP leader Shahnawaz Hussain and Kapil Mishra also reacted to the post, social media post written by Zafarul Islam Khan and the entire controversy. So, let us hear what they have to say about this as well.
ठेका ले रखा है कि उन्होंने भारत को बदनाम ही करना है। जिस तरह से आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता और दिल्ली अल्पसंख्यक आयोग के दिल्ली के चेयरमैन जफरुल इस्लाम खान ने जिस तरह की बातें बोली हैं, इसकी मैं घोर निंदा करता हूं। इस तरह की बातें नहीं बोलनी चाहिए। किसी भी कंट्री को भारत के अंदरूनी मामले में दखल देने का अधिकार नहीं है, चाहे वो अरब कंट्री ही क्यों न हो, क्योंकि इंडोनेशिया के बाद सबसे बड़ी मुस्लिम आबादी भारत में रहती है और भारत में मुसलमानों के लिए भारत से अच्छा देश और मोदी जी से अच्छा नेता नहीं मिल सकता, जो 130 करोड़ लोगों को इकट्ठे रख रहे हैं, एक निगाह से देख रहे हैं। लेकिन किस तरह से भारत को बदनाम किया जाता है, एकाध छोटी घटना को लेकर किसी मुल्क को दखल देने का कोई अधिकार नहीं है। और जिस तरह आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता ने इस तरह की जबान बोली है और जिस तरह का बात लिखी है, इसकी घोर निंदा होनी चाहिए और उनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई होनी चाहिए। किसी को भी भारत को बदनाम करने का अधिकार नहीं दिया जाना चाहिए। और जैसा करके दिल्ली माइनॉरिटी कमीशन के चेयरमैन जफरुल इस्लाम खान ने बहुत बड़ा अपराध किया है।
देखिए, दिल्ली अल्पसंख्यक आयोग के चेयरमैन जफरुल इस्लाम को अपने पद से हटना होगा। ऐसी घटिया, जहरीली और आतंकी सोच वाले व्यक्ति को किसी संवैधानिक पद पर नहीं बैठाया जा सकता। और हम दिल्ली के मुख्यमंत्री अरविंद केजरीवाल से ये मांग भी करते हैं और ये चेतावनी भी देते हैं कि तुरंत जफरुल इस्लाम को उनके पद से हटाया जाए। जो आदमी आतंकवादी जाकिर नाइक का समर्थन कर रहा हो, जो आदमी ये कह रहा हो कि देश के अंदर हमले करवाए जाएंगे, इस प्रकार की जहरीली और भड़काऊ भाषा का इस्तेमाल कर रहा हो, वो अल्पसंख्यक आयोग का चेयरमैन बनने के लायक नहीं है। आप खुद सोच सकते हैं कि वो दिल्ली के जो अल्पसंख्यक हैं, जैसे जैन समाज, सिख समाज, ईसाई समाज, पारसी समाज, बौद्ध समाज, इनके साथ किस प्रकार का व्यवहार करते होंगे, क्योंकि उनकी सोच जहर से भरी हुई है, उनकी सोच में आतंकवाद बैठा हुआ है। तो जफरुल इस्लाम को तुरंत तुरंत पद से हटाया जाए, ये हमारी मांग है और ये हमारी चेतावनी है।
Now be the first to know about the latest updates on our new news app. Go on your Android or iOS, search for HW News Network. Download our app, choose the language you prefer to get updates in, and be up to date with the latest news.
If you like this video, please share it, and we would love to hear your comments in the comments section down here. Also, please do like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter to get minute-to-minute news updates. For more such shows and videos, well, subscribe to our YouTube channel.